139, 140, 149, 134, 135, 137, 153, and 146. These five groups have shown me their presentation. Okay, so here I come at the roll number 138. Asia, the rest of the students, see, your next practical in the practical list, I think we have almost completed our practical list. So, just to be sure, just tell you that if one practical is remaining, we need to do 10 practicals only. Okay. Practical 8, you please wait till I complete this algorithm in class. Okay. And you can go for practical 9 and for your optimization that you must have done with Chirag sir in the lecture. And for the practical 10, you can go for sentiment analysis using analytic. So the rest of the students, they can use the Python library, NLTK, and give me a sentiment analysis for some movie, okay? So for movie, you can give me for any particular subject, you can give me for any particular data set that you have from Twitter or anything, okay? So you can give me the sentiment analysis. That's a very simple practical one of NLP. And those 10 practical, we will be completing our practical list. Okay? Done, students? Okay? So, as a last practical, you do sentiment analysis using a Python library. That is very easy. I guess 20 to 30 lines of code would be there hardly. So, you use that library and give me the analysis and I'll check. Every student should be having a different topic or a data set. Okay, so you can download a different data set from the internet and you give me the response about it. So I'm starting to evaluate 138 roll number. 138 roll number, will you please turn on your mic?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, who else is there in your group?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. ID number 143 here. I will present the screen, ma'am.
19 DCS.
143. Yes, ma'am.
Rest of the students, you remain in the lab and work it out on the last practical. If practical file is completed, I'll check and give you the marks for the 10 practical. So Vedant and Isha, you please give me your evaluation for the project.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Can you see the screen, ma'am?
Huh? Yes.
Can you see the screen?
Yes.
Okay. So good afternoon, ma'am. Today I had like to present our AI project presentation. Next. Our project topic is a caption generator. So basically, caption generator is the challenging artificial intelligence problem of the generating a human readable textual description given a photograph. Next. This is the contents of today's presentation. We will explain this topic one by one. Next. So this is the introduction. Our project is based on an image caption generator, which is a task that involves the natural language and the CNN to recognize the contents of an image and describe them in a natural language like the English. And the requires both image understanding from the domain of the computer vision and a language model from the field of natural language processing. So this is the definition. Image caption generator is a popular research area for the AI, and it's deal with the image understanding and language description for that image. So it's require both understanding of the domain of computer vision and being able to describe the contents of the image using accurately from sentences is a very challenging task, but it could also have the great impact by helping visually impaired people better understand that content of the image. Next. This is the hardware requirements of our project. So you can use Intel Pentium Minimum and
हेलो इच्छा यू कैन कंटिन्यू
यस
मुझे
समझ में नहीं आ रहा हमें हार्डवेयर सॉफ्टवेयर रिक्वायरमेंट हार्डवेयर रिक्वायरमेंट हमारा हो सकता है कि हमें जीपीयू
मैम आपकी वॉइस कट रही है
हार्डवेयर रिक्वायरमेंट कितनी रैम में हो जाएगा
मैम दिस इज नॉट एक्यूरेट वी रोट एप्रोक्सीमेट
मिनिमम
आप बताइए
ओह नो नो मैम आई थिंक इज देयर इज अ मिस्टेक इन द रिटर्न मिनिमम टू 2 GB मैम
और इंटेल पेंटियम में और इंटेल कोर में अरे मैं 10th जनरेशन i5 लेके बैठती हूँ मैं आपको मुझे खुद को 10 बार सोचना पड़ रहा है कि इसमें कर के नहीं कर वर्ड प्रोसेसिंग तक भी इंटेल के प्रोसेसर अब ठीक से कर नहीं पाते हम कहाँ उस पे ये रन करेंगे CNN चेक कर लो हार्डवेयर रिक्वायरमेंट
ओके मैम वी विल एडिट इट इन लेटर
आपका कौन सा है लैपटॉप में इंटेल कोर i3 i5
i5 मैम
i5 और जनरेशन आई गेस अभी तो 9th या 8th जनरेशन मीडिया होगा
यस 8th जनरेशन
जरा चेक कर लो हम पेंटियम कहाँ लिख रहे हैं
ओके मैम
डेवलपिंग के लिए लिखना है ना ये चलो चेंज कर लो ये एक्चुअली जरूरत नहीं है आप तो जनरेट ही करा रहे हो चलो कोई बात नहीं
ओके
इसकी ये
ओके इन द टूल्स एंड टेक्नोलॉजी वी यूज CNN दैट इज कन्वोल्यूशनल न्यूरल नेटवर्क आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सपांड इट मोर like CNN are specified deep neural networks which can process the data that has input shape like a 2D matrix. Images are easily represented as a 2D matrix and CNN is a very useful in working with images. CNN is basically used for the image classification and identifying if image is a bird, plane, animal, etc. Like it scans the image from left to right and top to bottom to pull out the important features from the images and combine the feature to classify it images. That's how CNN works. And the other thing we use is LSTM, which is a long short-term memory. Like they are a type of RNN, which is well suitable for the sequence prediction problems. Like based on previous text, we can predict what next word will be. It has proven itself effective from the traditional RNN by overcoming the limitations of RNN, which is a short-term memory. An LSTM carries out relevant information throughout the processing of input with a forget gate, which is discard the non-relevant information. I would like to show you the snapshot of the project. Like here is we input the image, and it will use the CNN, then LSTM. Then it will classify the description. Like here, it shows the 5 different captions. We can choose anyone, or we can use any of these. Another one is example is this. Like in image, we can see that the captions are generated with the use of first CNN, then LSTM. Now here are some of the reference links, which is useful for our project, and there are some other projects which are currently executing in the real world. And in the conclusion, I would like to say in this project, with the help of concept of neural languages like CNN and LSTM, we develop image caption generator. CNN is used for extracting features from the image, and LSTM will help the...
I'm back again. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So let's start. And please, we wish all me a lot that next time there's no power cut during this lab session.
Okay.
So after the presentation. You can see your screen now. Yes, conclusion and references.
Yes,
you
ma'am.
Can you please just run a demo for me?
Sorry, ma'am.
Run a demo for me.
Okay, ma'am, but it will take 5 minutes. Like we have to start a Jupyter, you know.
Okay, you can have 5 minutes for that. That's fine.
Okay.
Till then, I'll take presentation of something else. Okay.
Okay.
Goal number 139 is done. 140. Actually, let me check my list. 140 is also done. 142.
Yes, ma'am. Hello, ma'am. Am I audible? Okay, ma'am. So, halfway the ID number 159. So, can you please make us a presenter?
169 is there with you?
No, 159.
Yes, ma'am. 159.
159.
Yes, ma'am.
So, 142. And 159.
Yes.
Both are present. You can continue. Artificial mouse. I can see your screen now. You can continue. If somebody is speaking, I am not able to hear that. Okay. Just now I can see artificial mouse pointer, artificial intelligence, bye. So who is going to speak?
Yes, ma'am, Devang is going to speak first, ma'am.
Okay, Devang is muted at this particular moment. So he needs to unmute and speak.
Sorry, ma'am, my mistake. So our project name is artificial mouse pointer. It is prepared by me, Devang Soni, and my friend Nihar Jatakya. So working of our AI pointer. So this pointer takes a hand gesture command from the user, and by using library and packages, it decodes the signals and perform tasks. Because of artificial intelligence and computational calculation, it recognizes the user's finger within bounded area and only works in bounded area zone, which you will see in demonstration video. So it creates an artificial plane where user uses it as a mouse pad and tracks index and middle finger and use the gesture to as command. Now Nihar will take over from this. Nihar?
Yes, ma'am. So my name is Nihar Jatakya, ma'am. So these are the tools and technology and library and packages that we have used. Tools and technology in tools, Python 3.7 version, and for tools, webcam. Next, please.
And these are some the libraries we have used. OpenCV,
yes.
MediaPipe, NumPy, and AutoPy. So Nihar will give the brief information about these libraries and packages.
So yes, ma'am. Using artificial mouse pointer, we can eliminate use of mouse, but not 100% because of this. Here we have used OpenCV. With the use of OpenCV, we will be reading the video from the webcam using OpenCV and perform the hand tracking and landmark estimation using MediaPy. For calculation, we use NumPy, and for the GUI toolkit, we have used AutoPy. Next, please.
So here are some implementation video. So it is screenshot of output screenshot. And now live demonstration video, which we have captured yesterday night, as you can see. It's still in a, it's still running. After it starts, it will track the finger.
So ma'am, from the first finger we can use as a mouse, and from two finger and we will as close as possible we will do our fingers, it will click on a, it will use as a click.
Okay,
so
we can
use
yes
ma'am.
Thank you.
Nice one.
Thank you, ma'am.
Vedant, are you ready with your demo?
Yes, ma'am. Hello?
Yes.
I am sharing the screen. Ma'am. Can you see?
Yes, ma'am? Yes.
So, ma'am, we ran into Jupyter Notebook. Like, here are some of the libraries we use, the Keras and others. For the database, we use a Flickr 8K database. For the images, like data in data science and AI project, these libraries and databases are also useful. So we use that. So we are as we give the input from the for the image, it will load and this will the output. As we show you in the snapshots. Okay, ma'am.
Yes. Next who is? After 143, I have 146. 146 is already done. 147. Om, are you ready with your presentation?
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, so who is along with you?
No, I am only one. Like, I am the only one.
Okay, I have made you.
Okay, 1 minute. Ma'am, is my screen visible?
Yes,
sir. Hello, ma'am.
Yes, it is visible.
Okay, so yeah. Okay, good afternoon, ma'am. My name is Om Tak, and I have made a mini project for the artificial intelligence based on the Alexa virtual assistant. Basically, in this presentation, I will be covering what will be Alexa, how does it respond using AI, then I will show you my demonstration video, what are the limitations for this project and the conclusion for it. So basically Alexa is a virtual assistant, artificial intelligence technology for which is made for the easier and comfortable living of the people. So it is a basically a voice service that that is used to interact with the what we can say particular assistant through which we can do many things, like we can search anything like from the Google, we can play a song through it, like then we can get some information about the cricket match or something else like that. So why Alexa is required in such in nowadays? So as we know, the technologies has been getting higher and higher. So basically we are using touch phones and all that. So for the easy comfortable living for people, we should develop such a assistant through which after by speaking we can do anything like through which that machine can do anything and follows a command. So instead of controlling through our phones, we can able to talk with that virtual assistant and so that we can do the stuff that we want to do. So basically how the Alexa will be responding to us or our voice, basically it will catch up the word that we will be speaking from the whole sentence, and it will be we have imported some Python libraries for that, like basically like we can say we have to import speech recognition library, then we have to I have used like py WordKit, then I have used Wikipedia, I have used then I have used Python text to speech conversion, that library I have also used. So basically it will people will make some request and that will Alexa will recognize it and it will search for the specific word and then it will be converting it and it will be transferring to it and then it will give us the satisfied output that we want to know. So yeah, so this is the video demonstration video. So yeah, so I have run the code. Then I will be like I have
Barack Hussein Obama. Yeah. Listen, Barack Hussein Obama, born August 4th, 1961, is an American politician, author, and retired attorney who served as the 44th president of the United States from 2009 to 2017.
But when did you say who is Barack Obama?
Sorry, ma'am. Kya bola?
When did you say?
In this video it is not firstly okay take a minute like aage aayega ma'am ek hi minute
the current time is 12
okay nahi aa raha hai okay so video mein nahi aa raha but maine bola tha matlab tabhi wo aayega like maine matlab main jo yahan pe abhi video mein dikh rahe hai na what is the time so I have spoken it phir hi wo respond karega samne क्या बोला मैम आपने ऊपर हाँ मतलब हमने लाइक मैंने कोड में ऐसा लिखा है लाइक उसको एक स्पेसिफिक लाइक मैंने अभी पूरा लिखा है लाइक मैंने मतलब मैंने लिखा है हु इज बराक ओबामा तो लाइक इधर एल्स इफ में मैंने हु इज लिखा है फिर विकिपीडिया में से लाइब्रेरी में से मैंने लाइक जो मैंने इंपोर्ट की थी पाइथन की लाइब्रेरी उसमें से मैंने एक ही लाइन विकिपीडिया में से लिखवाई है लाइक वो यहाँ पे मैंने प्रिंट करवाई है नीचे जो कि जो विकिपीडिया में फर्स्ट लाइन होगी वही
और ये क्या आ रहा है www.bandicam.com
मतलब वो मतलब हाँ ये मैंने जो वीडियो एप्लीकेशन है वीडियो की मतलब वही मतलब जो वीडियो मैंने स्क्रीन रिकॉर्डिंग की है ना वो मतलब ये उसकी एप्लीकेशन थी लाइक बैंडीकैम
ठीक है चलो आगे
ओके सो या दिस इज द वीडियो लाइक सब लाइक वैसे हो जाएगा फिर लिमिटेशंस आर देयर लाइक फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर specifically limitations will be that like specific things we can only do with this type of device like right now that I have been making it so enough knowledge will not be there for that machine like specifically things that I will be doing is there only also it cannot perform multiple actions with only the single command or cannot perform any phone calls or that so yeah And from this project, we can conclude that the smart devices or the virtual devices will be performing a very good enhancing field to develop in the nearer future. Or Alexa should be a very good we can say a machine through which we can make our life comfortable and easier. So yeah, that's all. Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay.
Just a second. So overall good presentation, but I think a bit thoda apne speaking mein thoda problem. बाकी तो कंप्लीट.
Like ma'am, आपको demonstration देखना है?
आपने भी video दिखाया है.
हाँ वीडियो दिखा रहा
है.
लाइक मेरे पास है, एक मिनट मैं दिखाता हूँ आपको.
आप रन करो तब तक मैं दूसरे का प्रेजेंटेशन.
मैं स्क्रीन शेयर करके आपको रन करके दिखाऊँ ना, एक ही मिनट.
आप प्रेजेंटर हो ही तब तक दूसरे का प्रेजेंटेशन.
हाँ एक ही मिनट.
ओके धैर्य तो हो गया है. नील
यस मैम. Yes, ma'am.
बनाओ प्रेजेंटर.
लाइक मैम अभी दिखा दूं मेरा पास?
आपका चलेगा, आप नहीं दिखाऊंगी. जाइए आगे.
नील. मैम वी आर इन.
यस मैम.
आपको प्रेजेंटर बनाओ.
यस
नहीं स्नेह को मेरे घर लाइट नहीं है तो वाईफाई नहीं चल रहा.
तो आप और स्नेह दोनों को प्रेजेंटर बनाओ.
ना मैम ओनली स्नेह को, स्नेह ही पीपीटी प्रेजेंट करेगी. हम एक्सप्लेन करेंगे.
बोलोगे तो सही ना
मैम. इज इट विजिबल?
यस मैम.
यस मी.
इज इट विजिबल?
यस.
बेसिकली आवर प्रोजेक्ट इज ऑन रिवर्स इमेज सर्च कंपेयरिंग टू इमेज. इफ देयर आर सेम, इफ देयर आर प्रॉपर्टीज, इफ देयर प्रॉपर्टीज मैचेस देन इट विल गिव अ 1 और 0 मींस it compares the image. We have 3 person in group 157 150 and 154. Okay, content first is introduction. As I told earlier, we had used Caltech 101 and Caltech 256 data sets, and for learning we had used a neural network. Then first step what we are doing is that particular data set we are inputting
and-
the Is it visible? Basically what does there are three layers. First is input layer, then there is a dense layer, and last one is output layer. So what it does is in input layer two images will be inputted, then there will be a target in the data set, whether if it matches then 1 and if doesn't matches then 0. Then in a second step there will be extraction of data.
If you had screen blank ho gayi, black screen dikhi.
Yes ma'am.
Ab dikha screen blank ho gayi kuch.
Ma'am, in second step, what performs is W transpose X plus B. It means that type of calculation will be take place, and basically weights are decided in that. And finally, it gives out if we provide the two image or input the two image into the model, then it will give a 0 or 1. Say for the matches are, it matches or not. Then second, these are the roles and responsibility. Image searching algorithm is made by Neil. Yash is collect the data set and I had made a model.
Also there in this.
Yes, we had three. Ma'am, aana alawa bijo pan project kero, par aa ek best hai, etle aaj dekhadiya
chhe. Why Yash is not presenting or not saying anything about the work? यश कोई अलग प्रोजेक्ट प्रेजेंटेशन करने वाला है क्या?
नहीं मैम.
नाम क्यों नहीं बोला अभी तक? ओके डेमो शो करो.
डेमो सो दिस आर द फर्स्ट लाइब्रेरीज.
Mm-hmm.
એક્સેસ ટોકન મારું માંગશેસ ને
ગૂગલ ના જાણે છે ચાલે
પરમિશન નહીં હોય એટલે
હા બરાબર તારું માંગે છે રે આજે તે પેલું મોકલું જ ને ડેટા લોડ કર્યો જ ને એ તારા ડ્રાઈવમાં
એમ ગૂગલ ડ્રાઈવમાંથી માઉન્ટ કરેલી છે
ડાયરેક્ટ પેલામાં ઇમ્પોર્ટ કરીને
મારા ડ્રાઈવમાંથી આવેંગે ને
કરેલું છે મેમ એટલે કોડ માં લાસ્ટ માં આ બધું આ સમજાવી દઉં આ મતલબ કઈ શું છે ને બધું હા બેઝિકલી અહીંયા જે છે ને એ ઇમેજ જે પેલો ડેટા સેટ છે ને એ માઉન્ટ કરેલો છે બરાબર અહીંયા જે બધું પેલું કેટલો ડેટા સેટ છે પછી એની હાઇટ અને વિડ્થ કેટલી છે એ બધું અહીંયા ગોતી દીધું છે એટલે લાસ્ટમાં જ્યારે યુઝ કરવું થાય ને કરવાનું થાય ને એટલે યુઝ કરી લેવું અને અહીંયા એ ઇમેજ બેઝિકલી ખાલી પ્લોટ કરી છે ડેટા સેટમાંથી અહીંયા કે કે ટાઈપની ઇમેજ છે બરાબર પછી અહીંયા જે છે ને એ એક્સપેરિમેન્ટ છે આખો ઇમેજ પ્લોટ કરાવેલ છે કે જેમ કે એક સેકન્ડ હું ડાયરેક્ટ તમને આઉટપુટમાં કહું જેમ કે આ જે છે ને આખો ગ્રાફ હવે આ ન્યુરલ નેટવર્ક કઈ રીતના કામ કરે જેમ કે આ જે પર્ટિક્યુલર ક્લસ્ટર ફોર્મ કરેલા બરાબર એક ક્લસ્ટરમાં છે ફોર ઈ ટાઈપની ઇમેજીસ હોય ને બરાબર એક એમ્બેડ અગર આપણે ટેન્સર ફ્લો વાપરીને કરેલું હોય બરાબર તો શું થાય કે એમ્બેડિંગ લેયરમાં પાસ કરે ને અને હરેક ઇમેજ છે ને એક વેક્ટરમાં કન્વર્ટ થઈ જાય એ જ પર્ટિક્યુલર અહીંયા છે કે વેક્ટર એ ગ્રાફમાં રિપ્રેઝન્ટ કરેલું છે કે એ ઇમેજની આજુબાજુમાં કઈ કઈ વેક્ટર પોઝિશન છે ને એ બધી ક્લસ્ટર ફોર્મ થઈ જાય આખો ડેટા સેટમાં જે જે ઇમેજીસ આવે એ રીતના પછી શું થાય કે ગમે ત્યારે ઇનપુટ તમે આપો બે ઇમેજ બરાબર એટલે ક્લસ્ટરમાંથી ને ચેક એટલે કે અહીંયાથી કઈ સેમ છે કઈ નહીં એ રીતના બરાબર એટલે આ ટૂંકમાં એ જ રીતનું છે આ સીઝર્સનું ક્લસ્ટર બનેલું છે પછી અહીંયા સ્કોર્પિયનનું છે અહીંયા બોટનું છે સ્ટોપ એ રીતનું એટલે ન્યુરલ નેટવર્કમાં એ ક્લસ્ટર ફોર્મ થાય અને અગર આપણે આ આખો પ્રોજેક્ટ છે ને ટેન્સરફ્લોમાં કરેલો હોય ને તો એ સોફ્ટમેક્સ ફંક્શન યુઝ થાય એક્ટિવેશન ફંક્શન બેઝિકલી આખો ડિવાઈડ કરવામાં યુઝ થાય મલ્ટિપલ જ્યારે ક્લાસીસમાં તમારે કરવાનું હોય ને ત્યારે અને ઓનલી બાઇનરી ક્લાસિફિકેશન કરવું હોય તો તમારે એક્ટિવેશનમાં પેલું કહ્યું સિગમોઇડ ફંક્શનથી થઈ જાય ચાલી જાય આ ડિફરન્ટ આ મેમ પેલું મેં કીધું ને સ્કેટર પ્લોટ આખું પેલું કે કયું કયું રેન્જ છે આખું અલગ અલગ કલરમાં કયા કયા સ્કેટર ક્યાં ક્યાં થાય ને ક્લસ્ટર ફોર્મ થાય ને આ સેમ કલરનું એક ક્લસ્ટર છે પછી આ ઓરેન્જ કલરનું એક ક્લસ્ટર છે એ રીતના આખું ક્લસ્ટર બનાવેલા છે
બ્લેક સ્ક્રીન દેખાય
વોટ મેમ
મને તો કઈ દેખાતું જ નથી મેમ
બ્લેક સ્ક્રીન દેખાય છે મને
ઇમેજીસ જે છે ને હા એનું જ કલર ફોર્મેટ છે આ ઉપરની ઇમેજ આ જે દેખાય ને એ બસ મેમ આ જ છે આખામાં એટલે આ ઝૂમ કરેલો છે
મેમ એના આનો યુઝ કરીને મીશોમાં ને એમાં રિવર્સ ઇમેજ સર્ચ આખું આવે છે ને જનરલી આપણે પિન્ટરેસ્ટમાં ને એમાં બતાવે બી છે સિમિલર ઇમેજ એમેઝોન માં ઇન્ટિગ્રેટ થઈ ગયું છે સિમિલર હા એમેઝોન માં જ છે ડાયરેક્ટ ઇમેજ સર્ચ અને પિન્ટરેસ્ટ માં વધારે આપણે નીચે ડાયરેક્ટ સિમિલર્સ બધું ગૂગલ લેન્સ યુઝ કરે છે
ઇવન
ખ્યાલ એટલે એ એની જેવી એપ્લિકેશન બનાવે
નેબર વ્યૂ કરે છે પછી તમે કીધું કે ન્યુરલ નેટવર્ક યુઝ કર્યું છે એટલે હું કોડ જોવા માંગતી છું બીકોઝ મને એવું લાગ્યું કે કે નિયર્સ નેવર થી રિઝલ્ટ આવે છે
મેમ કેન વી લીવ ઓર
યે યુ કેન લીવ
થેન્ક યુ
152 I'm sharing my screen now.
Pujan will guide you through the PPT and I will guide you through the demo. If it's okay.
Sure. No problem.
Is my screen visible?
Yes. Smart reply.
Oh, okay, ma'am. So, hello, everyone. So, today we are here to present our mini project of AI that we have created. That is smart reply system that we have made by importing the model of TensorFlow, and these are the topics that we will be discussing throughout the presentation. So first of all, we will be discussing that what is smart reply, what is on-device smart reply model, or we can say what is this project about. So basically, this project is showing the that if anyone is messaging or texting or emailing to us, then we can reply in just a one-touch response or like a suggests us some responses smartly, like if you are asking that how are you, then I need not to waste the time to say that I am fine or that. The smart reply system will give us the reply automatically, and we can just reply to the person in by just one touch. And it is also time saving, that of course we are not thinking about anything, and just by we can do everything by the side by just one touch response. And resource efficient, that in this we have used that project and network demonstration that here the whole model is not trained again and again. It has pre-trained and then we have directly implemented in the device, so it will not take much resources to recalculate the all the process and will give the reply. So it will not take much time and resources. And then next is how to use this model. Then yeah, we can directly use this model by implementing it in our Android device. Like here, as I have written, that it can directly provide with the most optimal minimal word reply with just input recognition and its pre-processing. That if we will input the question or all the text, then it will just recognize the text, will pre-process, and will give us the suggestion that what we should reply and where it is used. That it is used in Gmail, as in inbox. We can see that as a mail has been came, then we can see that in the beneath the mail, we can get some suggestions that, yeah, I am fine, it's good, like that. Then it is allowed that it is a special application made by Google for smart replying. And then smart bands. And as we know that smart bands, the screen of the device are not that much big. So in small screen, we can reply instantly by just clicking on the reply that the model that has provided to us. And in messaging apps, if we are using the Google keyboard, as we know, then we can see about the keyboard that there are some suggestion of words or like reply that we can use and input it directly in our replying text. Now, ma'am, here how the data is pre-processed in the input, like when we take the input from the user, then how the data is pre-processed, like first it will split the sentence, that if there are multiple sentences, then it will be split completely and then tokenized, that each word would be tokenized, like it would be converted into different tokens and normalization, like it will make all the entities in lowercase and would remove the punctuations and all that stuff, so that the device can work efficiently and could not take much resources or time. And then response set generation, as it will pre-process the input data, then it will perform the response set generation. Like it will first canonicalize the responses. Like first of all the responses would be gathered, then as per the variability in languages, and then it will perform a semantic intent clustering. It means that if you want to all the similar meaning replies should be in the one place, like here, as we can see in this graph, that all like replies like great, awesome, all are divided concurrently, and we can find all of them in one place, like different clusters. And then the graph construction, like here, we will manually define the cluster sample from the frequent messages, and then graph is based. Well, each node of the graph is in the form of clusters. Like this is one node, this is one node, and then we will give it a semi-supervised learning that it will not only just reply the input text, but it will also think that if I would say that the input is that like when should we meet, if we say, then we can also say that Thursday evening or how about today. But it will also input another element, like it will think by its own and say that how about Friday. Like it will give us another point of view beside the input data. And then at last the cluster validation, that it will validate the responses, and it will show the top responses from the cluster, and we will be able to see that in our reply model that we will be seeing in the demo. Now from here, Irfan will present the demo. So Irfan, yeah.
Yeah. Ma'am, I am having some issues with laptop. Is it okay to directly show the demo in mobile Android app?
Yes, you can show it.
I'm stopping the screen share.
Is it visible, ma'am?
Yes, sir, front is visible.
Okay, so basically we inherited some of the abstract methods of TensorFlow model. TensorFlow is providing smart reply model by themselves. We have created some abstract methods on top of that, and we implemented it in an Android app. So this Android app will basically load the model. It does not require any kind of network connection or anything apart from just mobile RAM or memory. So our main plan was to build a complete chat application, but in the very short span of time and very small time to research on this topic, we just created this simple demo application in which we will provide the message and it will just directly give us some of the replies. So let's try this. So I'm writing like, how are you? And now, if I press on the generate replies, first of all, it will say this, okay, yes, no, because the model is not currently up. When the model will be ready, it will give the smart replies. Currently, it's not up, so it will give basic replies like, okay, yes, no, and thumbs up icon. So I will try something else, like, how are you doing? Now, I think, yeah, so you can see the smart replies here. It's not the complete chat application, but it will just show you the reply.
Like the one we have in LinkedIn or Facebook.
Yes, yes, exactly. We have that in LinkedIn. Yeah, just we have to tap on that tab and the message will be sent.
Yes, we don't need to type everything.
Yes.
Nice one.
So, that's all the message.
This was our project.
Yeah, it was very good. Presentation was also very good from the
thank you. Anything else, ma'am?
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Five minutes to this whole campaign. Who is next in the queue?
Hello, ma'am. There is a power cut in my area and my laptop is having much battery. So can we present our project first?
Okay, who is along with you, Pa? 172-181.
Okay.
You are presenter,
you can start. Okay. Is my screen visible now?
Hello?
Yes, it is visible.
So our project is a chatbot for admission inquiry for students and any other and for parents. So basically we have used PyTorch and NLP concept for this project. We have used topics like bag of words, tokenization and stemming. So what we have did is first, what is bag of words? Bag of words is a kind of an array which contains some words. And according to the user input, it determines which word is it and creates another array which contains ones and zero. For example, let me show you. For example, this is a bag of words. An example, this contains some words and a user gives input. For example, hello, how are you? So it will put one in hello places and you in one places. So this is how bag of words work. And other topic is stemming. Stemming is, it generally finds the root of this word. So here is an example. The word is organize, organizes, and organizing. The root of this word is organ. It will find this kind of root in the input. In the and tokenization, it will do nothing. Just it will divide a sentence in array. Divide the array will contain all the words and special characters inside the array. So this is our project. Now let me run it. So first we will say, it will say hi, it will reply hi, what can I do for you? So first of all, user wants to say what kind of courses are available. So it will type for admission and you just type admission. So it will say available courses are BTEC, MTEC and diploma. So for example, the user wants to apply for diploma. So it so he wants to know the eligibility to recruit as a diploma. So he will write recruit requirement and for diploma. So it will print the all the requirement for diploma. For diploma, 10th or 12th pass. For BTEC, what are the requirement for BTEC and MTEC? So here he has decided that he will do the course for diploma. Then what are the fee structure of this course? So he will write fees. So it will give just fees of diploma, BTEC, MTEC. So available fees are one lakh per annum, then per year, then BTEC fees and MTEC fees. It will also provide the transport fees if he wants to apply for a bus facilities. So he have decided he wants to apply for a bus facility. So he will try the transport, or he will just write bus schedule. So it will tell you the bus reaches at the stops around 7 p.m. and you can check the bus stop leads for at the transport department. Then after the So he wants to know what are the documents required for an admission. So he will write documents. These are all the documents he will require for admission. He will need a 10th or 12th mark sheet, living certificate from the school, two passport size photo, and one Aadhaar card copy. These are the basic or almost all the documents it will he will need for an admission. So next thing he wants to do. So he decided all of the he wants to he got all the information about the admission required documents and eligibility's fee structure. So he wants to visit the college. So what are the timings? So if he will just write visiting timings, it will provide the visiting hours for us. This is all the for a few. We are now adding some GUIs and it is on the way. Hello.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
Just a second. Okay, I have seen your backup words, that admission process when you did the document. It was nice.
So, can we leave?
Yes, just to check in, I need to note down the names. Three students are there?
Yes, ma'am. 181, 172 and 183.
Yes. Okay, I'm keeping presentations until this only, okay? Sorry, the rest of students, I cannot attend you today. I'll schedule your presentation this week or next week in the lab. Next week when I schedule the presentation, I request all my students to complete their pilot for the 10 practicals. So we are done with the evaluation also next by the next week. Okay?
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, can you take our presentation right now?
Ayushi? Okay. I can
see. Yes, ma'am.
Who is along with you, Ayushi?
ID number 173 and 176.
Okay. I have made all of you three the present.
Hello, ma'am. Visible screen.
Yes, social distancing with AI.
Okay, ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am. Our project is on social distancing with artificial intelligence. Next.
Hello, ma'am. Okay, so the project methodology presents for a social distancing detection using deep learning to evaluate the distance between the people to mitigate the impact of this coronavirus pandemic. The detection tool was developed to alert the people to maintain a safe distance with each other by evaluating a video feed. The video frame from the camera was used as an input, and the open source object pre-detection pre-trained model based on YOLO version 3 algorithm was employed for pedestrian detection. Okay, so what is YOLO? YOLO is a state-of-art object detection algorithm that has become the main method of detecting object in the field of computer vision. Previously, people used techniques such as sliding window object detection, RCNN, fast RCNN, faster RCNN. But after invention in 2015, YOLO has become become an industry standard for an object detection due to its speed and accuracy. Okay, now I'll explain that how YOLO works. YOLO algorithm first separates an image into a grid. Each grid self predicts some number of boundary boxes and around object that scorely high prediction predefined classes. Each boundary box has a respective confidence score of accurate. It assumes that prediction should be detect only one object per bounding box. The boundary boxes are generated by clustering the dimension of ground truth boxes and original data set of finding most common shapes and size. Later the video frame was transformed into top down view for distance measurement from the 2D plane, and the distance between the people can be estimated by non-complicated pair of people displaying indicated red frame and red line. Okay, next slide.
Our main objective is map to a real-time framework with the Python and deep learning. In this framework, we use the YOLO algorithm to analyze the social distancing in public area.
So our basic objective of our project is to our aim to support and mitigate the coronavirus pandemic along with minimum loss of economic and works, and the purpose of the solution is to detect the social distancing among the people that are gathered in a public places, and from this it will be helpful to minimize the COVID-19 spread among the people in public areas.
Okay. So how does it work? Detecting distance between the pedestrian from a monocular image without any extra information is not possible. One way is to ask the user to specify input leading distance estimate between the pedestrian. If the user could mark the two points of the frame that are 6 feet apart, using one could find the distance between different points of the frame. This would be between true if the camera was equidistant to all the point of the plane where the pedestrian are walking. The closer the pedestrian are the camera, they are bigger size. The closer the two points on the frame of the frame to the camera, the smaller is the actual distance between them. To cope with that issue, the code receives 4 points of input from the user to line the line that are parallel seen from the above. The region marked by the 4 points are considered ROI. The polygon shape ROI is wrapped into a rectangle which become a bird eye view. Okay, so here is the flow of our project. So which I have explained earlier, ma'am, that first we will load the camera frame, and suppose if there is no pedestrian in that video, then it will again ask to load another video. Then we will transform of into top-down view, measure distance between the pedestrian, and then after detecting the social distancing measurement and indicate a result in output frame. Okay, next slide.
We use a Python, PyCharm, and a GitHub to train the our YOLO module.
Okay, apart, can you show a live demonstration video which I had said earlier?
Yes. Show? It show?
No, it's still a PPT.
We can, I'm just able
to see the PPT screen. Hello, ma'am.
Yes. Yes, now the school is visible.
Okay, so as ma'am, this algorithm assumes high RAM. So ma'am, we had pre-record video because ma'am, I have 16 gigs of RAM in my system. Still ma'am, it's consuming 98% of memory. So ma'am, I pre-recorded this video.
You can make me see that video that you have.
Okay, ma'am. So ma'am, I told you that these are the 4 points. It will assume a user. Okay, next. Part play the video. Ma'am, it will take time because it will take more RAM. Ma'am, you can see that processing frames. Okay, ma'am. So, ma'am, in our project, there will be two outputs. Okay, ma'am. One output is for detect patch strength in original video frame. The first output of the code is the original video with detected patch strength in it. The patch strength are localized with the purple boxes, as you can see in video. And second one is bird eye view for patch strength. It is localized patch strength video from top-down perspective, which is bird's eye view, in a region of interest was marked by the user. And ma'am, the main thing is ma'am, parameters which we can see on a right hand side, which is three parameters we had passed that based on the bird eye view, a 6 feet distancing point marked by the user, the algorithm calculates the report following parameters. Okay, the first one parameter is 6 foot violation, the number of times pet strain violates 6 feet safe distance threshold. Second parameter is for stay at home index, quantifies how many people are staying at home compared to the normal routine patch train traffic. 0% means there is no change in the patch train traffic compared to the normal day. 50% means half of the people are staying at home. And the third index is for stayed social distancing index, quantifies the social distancing is being maintained. 50% means the half of an interaction while not 6 feet distance criteria. Okay, Parth. Can you show next slide, Parth? Okay, so ma'am, what we have researched till now is existing system versus proposed system. So ma'am, we had find these three links which are on internet recently available for this detection. So what are the drawbacks? A range of other research work rely manual tuning methodologies to identify people activities. Also, the performance of system may vary depend on the various factors such as backbone architecture, input image size, resolution, model depth, software, etc. Analyzing the above project, we proposed a new model which may not perform more which not may only perform more accurate and faster the state of art, but also will be trained and tested using a large composition data sets. It is challenging environment. We offer post detection and post processing analytics solution to mitigate the spread of coronavirus, monitors and display the percentage of people with indexings A stay at home index, social distancing index and 6 feet violation index. Ma'am, this was our project. Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
yes, I saw your project. No problem. Okay, main marks rakhti hai.
Okay.
Yes.
Ma'am.
Abhi nahi, abhi kisi ka nahi. Isliye main nahi. Ma'am only. Haan, lekin next week.
Ma'am khali.
Next week.
खाली वीडियो दिखा दे मैम, प्रेजेंटेशन नेक्स्ट वीक कर लेते, वीडियो देख लेंगे मैम.
अभी नेक्स्ट, आज या अभी थोड़े में काम बिजी हूं, प्लीज नेक्स्ट वीक कर, ठीक है? फाइनल इवैल्यूएशन के साथ मैम, आपके मार्क्स पे इफेक्ट नहीं आएगा, डोंट वरी मैम. थैंक यू मैम.
थैंक यू मैम. कैन वी लीव मैम?
यस, ऑल ऑफ यू कैन लीव.
ओके, थैंक यू मैम.
थैंक यू मैम.